Now we can start to work on the stem. I mean, if it breaks off, we can clean it up. Should be all right. Just going to change it back to 2000 now. Okay, so I'm going to turn the stem now. I'm going to use this half inch spindle gouge and just give it a slight shape rather than it just being a straight stem. I'm just holding the tool upright at the moment to get it down to a thinner diameter. Starting from the left, because I'm now creating a shaped handle, so it's a bit like a very shallow cove. So I've got to start on the left here and go towards the middle and stop. And from the right I need to do the same, start the cut and go downhill towards the centre. We've got a very shallow curve. I don't want to go back up the hill because I might get a catch. So you can see there's a cove. What we need to do now is just to take that down a bit more because it's still quite thick. It's probably, I don't know, at least half an inch. So now we've taken most of the wood out of there, I'll use this 3/8 spindle gouge. Just use the bottom edge of the gouge in a sort of scraping action. Across this inside face just to tidy it up a bit. I'm now going to turn it over so that the flute is 90 degrees to the rest. We'll take a little bevel out here. Okay, so we'll leave that like that, I think. So what I'm doing is I'm starting on the side, bevel rubbing, and then I'm twisting it as I'm coming around, so that the flute then becomes upright in the centre. The same from the right, I've got to hold it right over on its side. think actually on that end, instead of it being splayed like that, I think we'll just keep it straighter. Slightly wider one. Back to the spindle just to tidy up this corner. Maybe we'll just put a little detail in the stem. At this stage I need to sand the insides. It is a little bit tricky because I probably should have done this inside face before I did the stem. So I'm going to have to be really gentle now with the sandpaper because this is going to come flying off. Finally, I've sanded it, but I'm going to do the cellulose sander and the wax by hand afterwards, I think, because it's going to be too delicate, especially for the buffing the wax. So we can clean that up afterwards. What I'm going to do now is very carefully, without trying to hit this metal part of the jaw, go in with this 3mm parting tool and part it off in my hand. Now I have to go one-handed. I need to catch it. There you go. Spins off in your hand. Spinning top. So this is the final spinning top, now waxed. And it's turned out quite well.